Warren. I'm a third year vet student. I'm currently the wellbeing representative for our University of Surrey Veterinary Society. I'm going to tell you a little bit about the wellbeing services that we have on offer at the vet school here at the University of Surrey. For those of you who are applying now, who are watching this, whether it's your first time applying, whether you've applied before and perhaps not made it, or whether you're coming for another degree, making a change, coming from work, wherever you are at in life, it's okay to feel nervous about these changes. Everyone's in the same boat and everyone feels the same way. So rest assured, you're not alone. We're here to support you. So first and foremost, the University's Veterinary Society, or VetSoc, as we're known, we have a team of students which are dedicated to student wellbeing. So I head up that team at the moment. And what we do is we work throughout the year to keep everyone as happy and as healthy as we possibly can. So that might be through serious activities like taking on student concerns and voicing them at wellbeing forums, or it might be some more lighthearted activities like the numerous events that we run throughout the year. We do things like fruit and veg giveaways, handing out chocolates, we celebrate different international days, and do things like weekly wellbeing recipes on our social media, for example. So a fantastic initiative that we have, that we run, especially for you guys, is our Vet Family Scheme. So within the first couple of weeks of you arriving, you will have been sorted into vet families if you've decided it's something you want to do. And what this means is that we will put you together with some siblings from your year, and we'll also give you some parents from the year above you. You'll be put together, and during our Vet Freshers Week, there'll be some fun events like a scavenger hunt and things like that that we normally do each year. This is just to give you a bit of a support network, some people in older years who you can ask questions to and get to know some people in your own year as well. So the staff body of the vet school also has a number of trained wellbeing champions like we do at VetSoc, as well as a tutor system. So this is to give you a full support network for essentially anything you might need them for. So the tutors are generally mainly there to serve your academic needs, but they're a great point of contact to have for any issues that you may have, regardless of what they are, essentially. They'll check in with you regularly, make sure that your study is going okay and that you are feeling happy and satisfied with how things are going. If it's out of hours and you're not sure who to contact, the university security teams are a really good resource and they're always there to help people whenever they're needed. But we also have two student volunteer services which are run out of hours, which are the University Nightline, a phone listening service, and the Welfare Watch, which is a group of student volunteers who look after people and support them if they're out and about at night. So the Students' Union has a lot of connections with other charities such as Samaritans, which is fantastic because they very generously provide us with drop-in services, wellbeing events, and so on. That's a brief overview of what we have to offer. There's lots more behind the scenes, there's lots more in the works. If you want to learn more, you can check out our Student Union website where they've got lots of our wellbeing activities and the Student Union wellbeing activities listed. I hope that's given you a bit more of an idea of what we have to offer wellbeing wise here at the University of Surrey.
Hi there, my name's Yasmin and I'm a third year veterinary student at the University of Surrey. I came to the university in 2017. In terms of getting into vet school, I actually only decided I wanted to be a vet when I turned 30 and ended up with a pet cat. I'd always been told at school I wasn't very good at chemistry and sciences, but what I did was I actually did an access course to get into vet school because I was working full-time as a child protection social worker, which involved quite long days giving evidence in court, report writing, so I had to be able to manage my time. I think from my perspective as a mature student, it was really important not to play down the skills that I was already bringing to vet school. So the fact that I've already studied law and social work to postgraduate level, worked in a very high pressure, challenging environment, and what that meant in terms of how that would transfer over to being a vet. My advice in terms of applying to vet school is don't forget what's made you who you are so far. Life is very much a journey. Every one of us has something different to bring to not just vet school, but future jobs and different aspects of life, and it's important that that really stands out both in your written application but also at interview. So I would say enjoy the process of applying to vet school, enjoy the interview, really use the day to sell yourself and get across what it is that you will bring to vet school but also to the future veterinary profession. And don't be afraid to ask questions. But otherwise, good luck, and we look forward to hopefully seeing you at Surrey.
Hello there, my name's Kieran. I'm a fourth year veterinary student here at Surrey, and I come from France, so I'd like to talk to you about a few things I would have liked to have known before I started here at vet school as an international student. So first things first, placements, we call them EMS here. We have to do a total of 38 weeks for our degree. First 12 weeks are based around animal husbandry that we do in our first 2 years, and then we've got 26 weeks that we then do in our other 3 years, and they are clinical placements. The important part that you need to know as an international student is that we have to do all our core weeks in the UK. Ensure you know what requirements are needed to apply to vet school, especially when it comes to grades or test equivalents for like French baccalaureate or international baccalaureate. Another thing I wish I'd known was the course and its structure. It changes and improves every year, but when I started I didn't feel like I knew enough about it, and so you can check on the Surrey website about it or ask someone during an interview day. I know it's particularly difficult for international students to attend open days, so that's why I suggest asking about it during an interview day. When you actually get here, what you need to remember is that the course is going to get gradually harder and harder as you go along. I wish I'd known sooner and got more involved while I was in first year with regards to societies and extracurricular stuff and maximise my time like that, because you never have more time than you have in first year, so I suggest just going out and having fun.
So I hope that we've been able to answer most of your questions about the admissions process and about the course. And I hope that we can welcome you to Surrey Vet School at some point very soon.